السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. As the month of Ramadan approaches and we are preparing ourselves physically, spiritually to revive our spirits and revive our iman in the month of Ramadan by trying and using it so we can take the most out of the month of Ramadan. One of the very beautiful ways of taking benefit from the month of Ramadan or of the month of Ramadan is by way of dua. And subhanAllah, many of us might already be making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, probably after every obligatory prayer. After every fard salah, we try to make some sort of dua, which is great, alhamdulillah. But a lot of times those duas that we make are usually the duas that we heard the imam make, or we learn from other people. And when we make these duas, it's more of just a routine than actually thinking about what I'm saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and actually asking for something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like for example, when we pray our salah, we recite Surah Fatiha in every single raka'ah. But subhanallah, how many of us actually thought about I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance in every single raka'ah? I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this beautiful dua I'm making in every single raka'ah. Likewise, when we make dua after salah, we need to be attentive and focused on what exactly it is that we are asking, so our dua has some meaning to it from our aspect as well and our perspective as well. So when we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is best to obviously make the du'as that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made and those du'as which are mentioned in the Quran, such as رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. And all these du'as are mentioned in the Quran. There are many du'as that are mentioned in the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as well. And then after that, when we are basically done reading the du'as that we know, we should speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a language we're very comfortable with. For some it might be Urdu, for some it might be Arabic, for some it might be English, for some it might be Bangla, whatever language it might be. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a language that we're comfortable with. And talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this very dua that sometimes we take for granted, الدُّعَاءُ مُخُ الْعِبَادَةِ. This is the essence, this dua is the essence of ibadah and worship. So when we talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, I am dependent on you. Because this is a quality, when we can show this to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to see this quality from His slaves, from His people, from the people who worship Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves this quality. And therefore, we need to resemble this quality and bring this quality into our lives by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because then that also reminds us that yes, I really and truly need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that gets us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of that connection of actually conversing with the Prophet, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, excuse me. So when we make dua, we should make it in a way where we're comfortable with what we're saying in a language whatever language we use, we're comfortable in speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that language and also putting everything in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Allah, I need this. Oh Allah, I'm having this difficulty. Oh Allah, please help me here, this, that, whatever it may be. And definitely the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come through that. So when we make dua, be focused and attentive in the dua that we are making and try that after every fard salah, we are making dua and extend the dua. Sometimes it's only 30 seconds, 40 seconds, sometimes maybe a minute. It's okay to be the last one there, or sometimes staying there for a little longer with our hands up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and making dua. Because again, we are trying to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and no one else. And really, 30 extra seconds isn't really going to take away from anything from us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the ability to prepare for the month of Ramadan. And when the month of Ramadan comes, we are fully well equipped and prepared to take the most out of the month of Ramadan. Jazakum Allahu khayr wa akhiru da'wana. الحمد لله رب العالمين.
يا صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيب